internet as we know is changing from Web 2.0 to Web 3. This is a very exciting time, and you must understand what Web 3 is if you're an interested investor, or potentially if you're just interested in the development of tech. And in this video, I'm going to explain exactly what Web 3 is and how it's changing the world in which we live in. Nothing I say on this channel is financial advice, or do your own research before investing any money. Let's get into the video, guys. Web3 has a potential to be just as disruptive and to usher in a significant paradigm shift as Web2 did. The fundamental ideas of decentralization, openness, and increased consumer usefulness form the foundation of Web3. Web3, often known as Web3, is the next step in the development of the internet. What does that all mean? Sounds very confusing, but don't worry, I'm going to explain it all. So if you were not aware, we're actually in the third iteration of the internet. Now, the internet started in the 1990s. Maybe end of the 80s, not exactly sure, but that was with Web 1. And what Web 1 was effectively allowed you to log in to view different pages. You didn't have the ability to interact with the internet in any way, but you had the ability to learn things, perhaps by reading different documents and also being able to send a few emails as well. Now, that was Web 1, and obviously there was a need for an upgrade. Although Web 1 was very useful, Web 2 allowed us to start interacting with the internet. That meant that we were then able to start posting things on the internet. So you think, for example, Instagram, Facebook. As well as that, you were able to go and buy different things from the internet through web stores like Amazon. And that has basically been what we've been living through since the early 2000s. And some of the names in the game, you know, Amazon's, Google's, I've already mentioned, have grown absolutely enormous and have really benefited from the growth of Web 2. Now, Web 3 is a slightly different thing altogether. Whereas Web 2 is centralized on different servers, such as the Amazon Web Service, this means that those huge companies have basically a monopoly of the market. And through that, they can basically control a lot of different things. You are providing data to the internet all the time, when you're browsing on YouTube, when you're searching for things on Google, when you're looking at Facebook. This data is then owned by the web services, and they will then go and redistribute that data, study that data as much as they want, without you basically having any ownership. If you want to upload something onto Instagram or Facebook, and those particular platforms don't like what you're uploading, they can then just remove it and have ultimate control over you. This video that's being uploaded to YouTube doesn't actually ever belong to me. Once it's uploaded onto YouTube, YouTube can take it down whenever they feel like it. This is a bit of a problem with Web 2, in that delivery of any content or delivery of anything really requires a middleman to be able to participate in an exchange. Web 3 is a completely different beast altogether. It's a decentralized internet. It is built directly onto the internet and not onto various different web services and cloud services. This makes it extremely cheap and extremely fast compared with the existing internet we use today. Other benefits of decentralization are that we become the owner of our own data, which means we can own data and then sell it back to various people who are using that data to be able to provide us with services. Also, if you think about a decentralized version of YouTube, I'll be able to upload whatever I want, whenever I want, without YouTube having any say in what I deliver to the platform. And ultimately, if I then want to watch videos and things like that, I'll probably get rewarded for doing that as well, because there's no centralized authority in control of anything. Now, Web3 is basically built on the blockchain, and cryptocurrency has come around as a currency to make all of this possible through smart contracts and through various different token exchanges. Now, when we talk about Web3, we think about all the opportunities that that's going to present. It presents trustless solutions, which is also very cool. Now, if I want to send you money, say I'm living in the UK and you live in America, I have to send money via my bank to then Swift, an intermediary, who will then send it to your bank and the other end. And through all those transactions, everyone takes a piece of the pie. So I am losing money on every single way through that transaction. However, if you hold a cryptocurrency wallet, I can send direct to you without the need of any intermediary, any middleman, through a trustless solution. When I say trustless, that means that there's no one there who has to be trusted in order to make that transaction take place. And this is coming in for a variety of different things now. If we think about the rise of NFTs, NFTs right now, we're thinking of profile pictures and things like that. But if we think forward, we can think about contracts, contracts for houses, contracts of ownership for cars, for all sorts of different things. And the more this is basically automated through an automated system, the cheaper everything gets. gets and the more efficient and better everything gets, because there's less room for tampering on the blockchain. People can come in and they can create contracts, but they can't come in and alter the contract once it's already been created, and no one else has the ability to do that either. This then leads into things like GameFi and online gaming, online sports betting, and everything like that, where you get tokens like Chainlink that are uploading real world data onto the blockchain through various different oracles. That information can then not be tampered with and is ultimately taken from a variety of different nodes in order to ensure accuracy. Now, Web3 is being built on a variety of different platforms, but one of my favorite ones is Internet Computer, who are building the next generation of internet. I talked earlier about being able to build directly onto the internet, and they do this through what is quite a complicated process and definitely worth coming and checking out the website, through something called canisters, which are ultimately the smart contracts. And this enables for insanely fast and insanely cheap transactions. And this solves a $3.9 trillion global problem, $3.9 trillion that go to the likes of Amazon Web Services, Google Clouds, etc. And as we come down below, we can see all the different decentralized apps or dApps that are being built on Internet Computer right now. And you've got various ones from NFT stores to a Web3 gaming infrastructure, to a decentralized Reddit, to a decentralized WhatsApp, to a Google search equivalent called Kinnick. And there are tons of different ways in which this can help other people. What else is cool about Web3 is it enables creators to come in and be able to create all sorts of different things, from different gaming to different metaverse worlds. And this will enable other people to use their platforms. It's creating ultimately a much fairer level playing field for people using the internet, where you as a consumer can also start to perhaps earn rewards through just participating in various things, such as watching videos, such as answering questions on Reddit or anything like that. This is the future of where the world is heading, towards a trustless economy where we lose the requirements for middlemen to ensure that we have a wholly more accurate and more secure, but ultimately cheaper service being provided to us. Now, you've probably heard of ChatGPT, which is now hugely noteworthy around the world, as it's basically an incredible platform that allows you to find human-like answers for pretty much any question you can think of. We also have other programs like Wolfram Alpha, which is a computational intelligence. What this means, you can basically give it all sorts of different problems and tasks, from things like English literature to math, geometry, and all sorts of different ways in which you can benefit from using something like this. Now, while many people are saying, well, this is going to completely destroy the traditional schooling system, whether that's a bad thing or not, I don't really know, but it's going to give people so much more time to think creatively, because all of the other tasks and things are then taken up by other programs. We've also got AI doing tons of other things, such as analyzing big data and conducting various learning tasks, enabling people to trade cryptocurrencies without having to learn how to trade, enabling maps to be able to give you the best route that you need to take in your car, enabling you to understand different ways in which you can interact with various web services in order to gain the very best output for yourself. Another huge part of the rise of Web3 is GameFi. Now, GameFi is basically connecting the world of online play to earn gaming, where you can earn physical or digital rewards in cryptocurrency you could then cash out into whatever currency you want, combined with traditional gaming. Now, I say traditional gaming, but as we know, gaming is completely changing all the time. We've seen a huge rise in mobile phone gaming in the last few years with the rise of the smartphone, and basically with economic development happening across large parts of the world. Now, that's also given rise to blockchain gaming, which is forecast in 2026, having basically just come in around 2016, to be worth $67.4 billion. That is hugely disruptive in this industry, and we're going to see a whole complete movement happening very quickly because of the rise of Web3 and all the possibilities it's going to present us. It's a very exciting time. If you don't really understand what Web3 is or all the applications and benefits from it, well, guys, you need to subscribe to the channel, because we're going to be talking about this regularly going forward, because it's a really disruptive technology and it's going to change the way that everything's done. And if you can keep up with it, there's so many opportunities and exciting things going on that you can be a part of in the next few years, rather than being left behind, like I'm sure many other people will be who don't have much knowledge of this. Guys, if you enjoyed today's video, then do me a favor, hit that like button for me. If you're new to the channel, you want to learn more about Web3, NFTs, crypto, and so much more, then hit subscribe, and I'll see you in the very next video. Bye-bye.